Quetzecoatl is out of luck this time. I wonder if there's a way we could have avoided getting sent down this pit in the first place. Okay, can I get this?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Okay, I guess we're just leaving that. I guess now other people go up? Guess I should have picked him last. I have a feeling something will happen to the last person. I'm not sure. Spockaroo? And Bonesy, too. We're all in a single file. I'm hoping we can actually walk somewhere up here. Maybe we climb the chain, or we can go either that way or that way. I'm not sure.
He doesn't seem to be in.
Those vines would be useful to escape.
We climb them.
Do I look like a Houdini to you?
Okay. Let's try to go, I guess, this way. Can we go back the way we came? I want to see if we can go the other way. Just out of curiosity, want to see if we can go this way. Or if that's the end. He won't move. Alright, never mind.
You are in a densely vegetated area. The overgrowth blocks your view in all directions.
Oh, goody.
Trees to the left of you. Trees to the right of you. Into the valley of trees race the landing party.
I think you're supposed to sound a little more excited than that, lady.
You are in a densely vegetated. You are in a densely veget.
Eyes.
Feral red eyes glare out of the. This great tree has been in this jungle for centuries.
Is there something up there?
You are in a densely vegetated. You are in a densely vegetated area. Trees to the left of you. Trees to the left of you.
Oh, God.
You look but see nothing of note.
Alright, I don't see much.
You are in a densely vegetated.
We're in a densely vegetated area. I'm gonna save now. Because I don't know where this is going. We still have the cute sneaky. We could use him to poison something, I guess.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Oh.
I am Toloxak, priest of Quetzecoatl. Only one who knows his ways may approach his holy ground.
One who knows his ways, huh? Don't stab me with that stick. I don't like it.
You look but see nothing of note. Primitive lights illuminate this savage scene. Primitive lights illuminate. Towering over your security officer, holding a great spear in his huge hand, the great warrior Toloxak will let no one pass him.
Toloxak, huh?
You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing. You look but see nothing of note.
Nothing's of note.
You look but see nothing of. You look but see nothing of note.
That's the moon.
You look but see nothing.
All right. Nothing of note.
You look but see nothing of note.
All right, shut up.
McCoy seems rather nervous. You are James Tiberius. Spock looks small compared to the great warrior.
Ah, but his mind is great indeed.
Your security officer looks at you for orders and perhaps inspiration.
Toughen up, soldier. You'll be just fine. Unless you die. In which case, you'll be dead.
Did you ever get the feeling that people don't like you?
He doesn't seem to...
Kirk's not saying all the neat things he used to say.
Perhaps our host will be more reasonable now. I recommend trying to locate him, Captain.
Well, there's something in our way.
Nice planet. I kind of like it.
I will not listen to your deceitful ways.
Huh? Can you look at this thing he's holding?
You look but see nothing.
Should we throw a rock at him?
Jaloxak falls to the ground unconscious.
He dropped a knife, Jim.
He's unconscious, Jim. I'm surprised that's all it took. I was ready to use the snake next. I figured that was gonna kill us. Alright, let's take the knife. Let's look at the knife.
You see a jewel-encrusted, gold-colored knife.
Nice. Holy knife.
Nothing unusual here, Captain.
Alright. We take the spoils of war.
You pick up the beautifully crafted knife.
So, our phasers don't work and our communicator does not work, but for some reason our tricorders work.
Nothing unusual here, Captain.
I find that funny.
The Aztec warrior lies on the ground, unconscious.
Will you be okay, Bones? Not that I really care, but I want to see what you have to say.
He's unconscious, Jim.
He's unconscious, Jim. All right.
Perhaps our host.
Can I do anything with these lights?
You fail to obtain anything.
Alright, let's continue on then, I guess. Hmm. We have some mushrooms here.
Below this rock is a large growth of mushrooms.
Hmm.
You are in a dark forest. You can hear the flow of water to the northwest.
Northwest. That'll be this way.
You are in a dark forest. Familiar glowing spheres light the path.
Familiar because we just saw them in the last screen.
You are in a dark forest. Familiar glowing You are in a dark forest. Lieutenant Strage smiles as he strolls down the path.
What do you think this is? A walk through the park, Strage?
Mr. Spock analyzes the surroundings. McCoy doesn't want to be bothered right now.
Well, tickle him.
James T. Kirk realizes that every step increases their danger.
Analyze these mushrooms.
Trowsakian mushrooms. Their spores are highly toxic and are released if they are disturbed.
Oh. Let's not disturb them.
I would strongly recommend against touching these, Jim. They're highly toxic.
Toxic. You know, in the first episode, we could analyze things that were in our inventory. And I...
Nothing happens.
We don't seem to be able to do that anymore. Can we walk around this way? Instead of going... He's just coming back. Don't touch the mushrooms. Oh my.
The log looks quite old, but sturdy.
There's a crack running right through the thing.
The river water is too muddy to get an idea of its depth, or what may be beneath its surface.
Hey, I've played Space Quest before. You don't walk into the water.
A pair of eyes are all that you can see of the rest of this creature. Most of it is hidden beneath the murky waters.
Yeah, I don't want to mess with that.
The river water is... There seems to be a lit cave beyond the log.
Cool.
You look but see nothing of note. There is a slow, muddy river blocking your path. A strong, thick log serves as a footbridge. The river is unmoving, and the heat and stillness are oppressive.
Mm-hmm.
This plant has a rather thick stem and prickly leaves. The river water is too muddy to get... The river water is too...
Well?
The plant is tough. You will need something sharp to cut it.
I wonder, do we have something sharp? Did I get something? Yes, I did. I don't suppose we can analyze this. analyze this time. The rest of it.
It appears that the leaves are slightly toxic. I would not recommend touching it for an extended amount of time, Captain.
Am I touching it while it's in my inventory? Can you?
There's nothing there requiring a ship's doctor.
Use your tricorder.
There's nothing there Jim, there's some kind of an aquatic creature down there.
No kidding.
The tricorder registers a life form, a large marine creature lurking just below the surface of the water.
Hmm. So we've learned that it's large. Hmm.
Nothing to report.
Alright. Do we get on this log? Do we just...
Save new game.
Yeah, let's do a new game. I don't know if this slightly toxic thing is gonna make him ill. And also... If I click here, I don't know if he's going to go on the log or just across the water.
Okay. Captain, it would not be wise to cross while the creature is near.
Captain, perhaps I should try to cross first.
You'll probably die. Let's throw a rock at it.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Throwing a rock, nothing?
Nothing happens.
What am I gonna do?
It would appear that the plant secretes a chemical that is a natural repellent to the creature. It has retreated far downstream, Captain.
Now how would I know how to do that? Okay, now let's cross. To the lit cave. Hooray. What's this? You guys are walking far ahead. Okay.
Darkness leading into the unknown.
Ooh. Into darkness? How did they know that movie would be released? This was made in 91? 92?
It is a large cluster of crystals.
Ooh. Cluster of crystals. I don't suppose these are toxic as well, Spock?
This appears to be a formation of raw dilithium crystals, Captain.
Dilithium, nice. Just want to see what McQuarrie might have to say.
There's nothing there requiring...
Let's get some.
You will need something to pry it loose.
Oh, like a knife or something? I'll say, it's not that hard so far, this adventure.
You have one dilithium crystal in raw form.
Nice. So I might regret saying that later.
They appear to be ordinary rocks. Spock's tricorder might say otherwise.
Spock's tricorder. Say what they are otherwise.
Fascinating. These rocks are limestone, but contain an unusually high content of heavy metals. There are dilithium crystals here, but in a very raw form. Fascinating.
What are these little twinkles?
Darkness leading into the unknown. Darkness leading into the... Stalagmites rise from the floor of the cave.
And stalactites descend from the ceiling of the cave.
You look but see nothing of note.
Or they're not of note.
Stalactites descend from the ceiling.
I should warn you, the stalactites could collapse quite easily. Any sudden motion could cause large quantities of stalactites to fall on us.
Well, isn't this just great?
Doctor, I would point out that your voice could also trigger such a collapse.
Will you two stop arguing just once?
He didn't say morons. I wonder if William Shatner objected to saying morons.
Then, gentlemen, I would advise you to stop arguing. You know, some shore leave sounds pretty good right now.
Oh, that's totally different.
Will you two stop... You know, some shore leave sounds pretty good right now.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the captain of a nursery school. I like that. See, I don't know if I choose this, if he's talking about some shore leave sounds good, or what is written here.
Then, gentlemen, I would advise you to stop arguing.
That seems like the sensible choice in any case.
It would seem to be a prudent course of action, Captain, if Dr. McCoy would agree.
What about yourself? And plus, you tell this now. We're halfway in the room, at least. This is hilarious.
Lieutenant Strage looks nervously at the stalactites hovering precariously above you.
Yeah.
James Kirk remembers the last time he was in a cave and is glad that this one seems more peaceful.
Emphasis on seems.
As usual, Dr. McCoy looks annoyed by the mission. Spock is his usual stoic self.
All right, let's talk to each other and make stalactites fall.
He doesn't seem to be in a talkative mood.
No, he won't talk to himself, but...
Reminds me of some spelunking I did on Hades 4. Ever do any climbing, Captain?
Have you ever made it up the face of Half Dome, Lieutenant?
If we ever get back to Earth, 100 credits says I'll beat you.
Captains and security officers, they don't realize how fragile the human body can be.
Sure we do. That's the challenge.
Half Dome, huh?
I've lost any appetite I may have had for squid, Jim.
Nah.
I would suggest we continue on, Captain. It would not be logical to endanger ourselves by remaining here.
I'm gonna save again, because since moving may make these fall. And I keep going into inventory when I want to save.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Let's forge on ahead and hope things don't fall on us. Victory!
I watched as you worked through the problems I set in your path.
Those were easy.
You are a valiant, intelligent species.
Oh, why, thank you.
Please sit down. We have much to discuss.
Huh. Was this your plan all along, this test?
I've had it up to here, with so-called superior beings terrorizing my crew because we're so primitive. Maybe you should see how primitive you are before you go around testing others.
I don't think that's a wise choice. This poor Lieutenant Strage here doesn't have somewhere to sit.
One thing first. If you're so peaceful, how come the Aztecs were so violent and aggressive?
Point.
Yes, I guess we do. Go on. I've had it. Yes, I guess we do. Go on.
I'm curious what he has to say, so rather than argue with the guy, let's just choose us.
First, I have one question. You are clearly not the liars I thought you to be. Were you telling me the truth about my disciples? That they became ruthless savages?
The Federation is not in the business of lying, mister.
This is the real Quetzalcoatl? I figured he was just someone taking his name. I guess I figured him for the liar. What's he doing out here on this planet in the middle of nowhere?
Absolutely. Your best intentions were changed by the imperfect humans that you left in charge after you departed. Such is the way of our race, I'm afraid.
And we're not the least bit surprised about this?
You messed up in a big way. Perhaps you should try following the Prime Directive. It changed our lives.
He probably doesn't know what that is.
The Federation doesn't... You messed up. Absolutely. Your best intentions were changed by the imperfect humans that you left in charge after you departed.
I sense truth in this. Perhaps this is what happened to my children on the Klingon world of Rakur, which would explain why they are searching for me. I have clearly abused the power that was given me long ago.
Mm. You show great wisdom, sir, but your statement implies that you wish to change your condition.
Indeed. If my mission of peace was overthrown, then I am no longer worthy of my power. Tell me, has your species made progress in the medical arts?
McCoy?
We're a technologically advanced starfaring race. What do you think? That we wouldn't have made progress in medicine?
So cranky today, Kirk.
With Dr. McCoy, I sometimes wonder, but yes, I would say we have made considerable advances. Yes, why do you ask?
Why do you ask? I'm very curious, sort.
At the top of my spine is a gland not found in your species. Oh. This is the seat of my power. I wish you to remove it, thereby making me immortal.
Jem, I'll try. But the physiology is completely alien.
You've got to do it, Bones. If the Klingons realize he's no longer a threat to them, perhaps we can avoid a war.
Interesting.
Scotty, 5 to beam up.
A clan. And now we're just beaming up. Was that fifth spot always there? I feel like checking.
Captain. 3 Klingon heavy battlecruisers have just entered the system.
Oh my.
Admiral Kenka is hailing us, sir.
Federation Starship, this is Admiral Blick Kenka of the Cleata.
Yes,
we harbor a criminal who has caused the destruction of the entire population of Rakkor. We are not prepared to negotiate. You will proceed to Rakkor, where a court of Klingon justice will be convened. If you refuse, we shall destroy you.
You!
Admiral Blick, the criminal of whom you speak is in the middle of a very delicate medical procedure. He cannot be handed over to anyone at this time.
He'll just open fire on us if we tell him that, right?
I cannot believe Quetzalcoatl's mission to Rakkor would cause the deaths of the entire planet. Since when do Klingons give orders to Federation officers, Admiral? I realize it's difficult for a Klingon, but don't be a fool.
Oh my!
Admiral Vlicht, the criminal of whom you speak, is in the middle of a very delicate medical procedure. He cannot be handed over to anyone at this time. I cannot believe Quetzalcoatl's mission to Rakkor would cause the deaths of the entire planet.
Which one? One or two?
Admiral Vlicht, the criminal of whom you speak, is in the middle of a very delicate medical procedure. He
Go on this one.
He cannot be handed over to anyone at this time.
Hope they don't open fire, because they'll probably kill us and... There's 3 of them, right?
His attempt to corrupt the Empire with his philosophy led to the destruction of all life on Rakkor.
How could a philosophy of peace and non-violence cause the destruction of all life on Rakkor?
Rakkor has been governed by my family for generations, but even they were corrupted by him. It was a matter of honor that his lies had to be silenced, no matter what the cost.
My God, you killed your own people just because they acquired a philosophy that you disagreed with?
You know, it's probably because they no longer had the will for battle, and they dishonored themselves. At least in Klingon eyes.
So you killed them. Your own family. You were responsible for their deaths, not Quetzalcoatl.
The truth is a hard thing to face, but else do we have?
You murdered them. You're insane.
Oh, it's even worse.
Tell me, how much do your commanders know about what you did? Or do you need to kill Quetzalcoatl to hide your own deeds? My God, you killed your own people just because they acquired a philosophy that you disagreed with?
One or two again.
So you killed them. Your own family. You were responsible for... My God, you
this
killed
one.
Your own people just because they acquired a philosophy that you disagreed with?
Any of these options is going to piss him off.
It was that creature's fault. Had he not interfered in our affairs, the people of Rakkor would be alive. Clearly he is responsible.
Message from Starfleet Command.
Oh?
I'll argue this with you later, Blicht.
Contact your superiors, Kirk. You may be surprised.
I have bad news, Captain.
Uh-oh.
The Organians have ruled that Quetzalcoatl's interference in Klingon affairs renders him subject to Klingon law. You are to turn your prisoner over to them at Rakkor. Klingon law will permit you to observe or aid in his defense. But be very careful, Jim.
Ow.
Starfleet out.
Captain, you cannot turn him over to those butchers. That would be murder.
Scotty!
You have no choice, Scotty. I'm afraid Quetzalcoatl has a date with Klingon justice. Set course for Rakkor, Mr. Chekov.
I think that's Scotty's second line in the whole game. Hello, Scotty. I want to hear more from Sulu and Chekov, though.
Captain's log. We have come to the ruined Klingon planet of Rakkor to deliver our guest, the mythical entity Quetzalcoatl, to a Klingon court.
Automatically.
Dr. McCoy, Mr. Spock, and Ensign Benny and I have been
Ensign
granted
Benny.
Permission by the Organians to witness this trial, which I expect to be a travesty of any meaningful definition of justice.
That's right.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the car.
Funny that they brought us here automatically, and this is where I was trying to come to in the first place. I could have just gone there myself.
The prisoner and his witnesses will stand forth, so the trial may begin.
Mm-hmm.